हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इट इज आईएएस कन्नड वाहिनी। क्वेश्चन पेपर दैट इज क्वेश्चन एनालिसिस आईएएस 2020 प्रीलिम्स। वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग विद द पार्ट सिक्स ऑफ दिस सीरीज। सो टुडेज क्वेश्चन इज सेम दैट इज ऑन द पॉलिटी, इंडियन पॉलिटी। द सक्सेस ऑफ इंडियन डेमोक्रेसी इज रेस्टिंग ऑन सेवरल फैक्टर्स रेंजिंग फ्रॉम पॉलिटिकल टू इकोनॉमिक। Which of the below given are the most important? This is the question. And we have given the four factors. First one, economic changes in the life of the people. Second, good political leadership in the initial years. Strong bureaucracy. Fourth, universal adult franchise and awareness. So these are the four factors. Among those four, you are supposed to select the answer. That is 3 and 4, 2 and 3. 1, 2, 4 and 1, 2, 3 and 4. So coming to the Indian democracy, that is in the post-independence era, how the democracy has established in India, what are the factors responsible for it? First one, if we want to see like from the political angle, it is a good political leadership given by the Prime Minister, first Prime Minister, that is Jawaharlal Nehru, who was also an active leader, that is during the freedom struggle. So who gave the good political leadership in the initial period? For any system, the good leadership and its stability are the two core parts, important parts or fundamental parts for the success of any political system in the country. If they are not given, if it is not given, definitely that system is going to fail. Whereas in India, it is a kind of, you can say, like the full of problems, like political problem, military problem or economic problems. Everything was there just after the independence. Still, people started believing in democracy. The reason was the good political leadership in the initial years for the 15 to, you can say, like 16 years. That's why definitely that factor is going to have the positive aspect. Next, we'll go for economic changes in the life of the people. So during that 1950s, during that period, almost 50 or more than 50% of the Indians were of like very poor people. It is the nation of poor people. So the political right did not have the meaning unless they had the economic right. So economic stability, economic empowerment was the main factor, or some kind of, you can say, like kind of the process of giving economic power to the people ensured that the democracy is gradually working well. Means in the form of, you can say, like the right to property, what I have given in the terms explained, right to property has been put under like legal right. It has been removed from the fundamental rights list. That is a correct decision. If we see the angle from the like economic justice or socialistic pattern of society, that kind of thing. So giving economic empowerment, economic right, economic justice, it plays an important role, that is in the democracy. Wherever there is a middle class, definitely middle class is going to ensure the stability of the democracy. Definitely up until you can say like 1980s, India didn't have that kind of the strength of the middle class. But thereafterwards, gradually the middle class became stronger and stronger. Its strength has been increased. Therefore, democracy is somewhat like working well. So that is the second factor. Third, we will come to the strong bureaucracy. So in case of bureaucracy, strong bureaucracy is definitely needed. It may be autocracy. It may be, you can say, like communist government or maybe like military government also, the strong bureaucracy can work. But it may not have the direct relationship with the success of democracy. Of course, the bureaucracy inevitably intervenes in the political matters, administrative matters. Still, it is not the direct point, direct factor, you can say, like giving some kind of basis for successful democracy. So that may not be the factor. Then fourth, universal adult franchise and awareness. Most of the countries in the world have not given universal adult franchise, considering the, you can say, like kind of poverty or inequality, etc. But from the day one, India has given the voting right for everybody who is eligible, that is above the age of 21 or like 18 years. So that universal adult franchise has given the common man some kind of power, political power, to change the political leadership in accordance with his own views, in accordance with the, you can say, like kind of nation, or like the positive aspect of the nation, progress of the nation, etc. And also, along with that universal adult franchise, the awareness, political awareness, is also has grown rapidly. One can say, like at the local level, like panchayat or municipality level also, people started taking part, that is in the elections or in the administrative or like participatory planning, etc. So that also played a very important role in the success of democracy. So election, what I have given like third term, election, that also played an important role. So these are the three factors, you can say, like economic changes in the life of the people, good political leadership in the initial years, universal adult franchise and awareness. These are the three factors actually can be accounted for the success of democracy in India. Naturally, the answer will be C, 1, 2 and 4. So for this question, answer will be 1, 2, 4. Now we'll come to the right to property. The right to property became a main obstacle, that is in the economic justice, or like the equality, that is in the society, social economic equality in the society. So that's why it was removed, that is from the, you can say, like 1978 onwards by 44th constitutional amendment. So that is also an important part, that is in the successful democracy of India.